Mellors and Sellers, a comedy thriller in four installments by Alan Melville, with Robert Lang as Sellers and Edward Hardwicke as Mellors. Part 1, Unnatural Hazard.
Last time we hear that at close range for a few weeks, thank God.
Amen to that.
Longest session I've ever yawned through.
Of course. If your lot hadn't kept coming up with all those damn silly amendments...
If your lot hadn't tried to cram in so many damn ridiculous bills...
If the budgie, your Mrs. Thatcher, hadn't kept on giving us all a wigging as though we were the fourth form at Rodine...
If Sonny Jim hadn't been so busy explaining that fringe benefits for hairdressers come within the social contract...
Do you know, old man, since this session started, I've barely seen my wife before 3 a.m. Then she's been sound asleep.
I've barely seen my wife. Well, barely, perhaps, isn't the word. Until 4 a.m. She's been out on the town.
Really?
With a liberal, too. That's the terrible thing.
Oh, well, it's our job, I suppose. Being whips. Even assistant deputy chief whips. You know what Shakespeare said, don't you?
Depends, old man. He said an awful lot in his time. Went on and on. Like old Percy Prostate, your chap from Bletchington North.
Bear the whip. And scorns of time.
Scorns of time is right. 38 all-night sessions. They say the Russians are going to launch a spacecraft to orbit the circles under the speaker's eyes.
Well, it's over, thank God.
Where are you going for the recess? Nursing your constituency?
My constituency doesn't require nursing.
Beyond care, I suppose. Must be returning you with a majority of 8,173.
Do you mind? 8,174.
Not so much a constituency as a geriatric ward. Where are you going?
I'm going to Lytham.
What?
Nothing wrong in going to Lytham, is there? Delightful place. One of the best golf courses in the country. I'm going to play golf, and I'm going to watch the International All-Amateur Championships, sponsored this year by 3 tobacco companies, 2 whiskey companies, 1 racing car tyre concern, and a chain of betting shops. Do you play golf?
No, stupid game. Walking all that distance to try and get a small ball into a hole that only just fits. It's like trying to get Willie Hamilton into the court circular.
Where are you going, then?
As a matter of fact, I'm going to Blackpool.
Blackpool?
But of course, being a conservative, I don't stay in Blackpool itself, I mean. But it wouldn't look right if I were found on the Big Dipper by one of your lot.
Or sucking an iced lolly on top of a tram in an open-necked shirt. Norman St. John Stevens wouldn't like it.
So I stay at St. Anne's.
St. Anne's?
What's the matter? You look as though Enoch Powell had risen on a point of order.
Well, I mean, Lytham, St. Anne's, they're one and the same town, really. Sort of coalition. Where do you stay?
I stay in a very charming little hotel called the Avant-Garde.
Oh, my God.
Now, what's the matter?
I am staying at the Avant-Garde.
A small world, isn't it? What train are you on?
11:15 to Manchester.
Me too.
Have you reserved a seat?
Yes, E17.
Isn't that extraordinary? I'm E18.
With any luck, they might be on opposite sides of the gangway. Shall we pair, as when your Percy Prostate is in bladder trouble and my Walter Incarnus is plastered?
I thought the great thing about a recess was getting away from it all.
So did I. Bye-bye, Barbara. Happy halls, Harold. Ta-ta, Ted. Good shrimping, Shirley. You don't play bingo, do you?
Good Lord, no. I'm a socialist. I only play the stock market and golf.
Well, we can go our own ways, follow our separate pursuits, and meet in the cool of the evening for the occasional snifter.
Sounds exactly like what we do here in the house.
You gentlemen together or separate?
Well, we're not exactly Siamese twins. We're lunching together, but paying the bills separately. Unless... Old man, you had thought of...
No. You'll be having your usual working man's bottle of Beaujolais.
You've got to support the common market, you know.
I, as a staunch Conservative, will have a pale ale. So we'll pay the bills separately.
Fruit juice, grapefruit segments, or soup?
What is the soup?
Oxtail.
Funny thing, it's always oxtail.
Why British Rail are so far behind.
I must say, the standard of repartee on your side of the house in the past session wasn't what you'd call sparkling. That did little or nothing to help. Fruit juice, please.
And for me.
Chicken or fish?
Has the fish that bright pink sauce all over it that tastes like damp blotting paper?
It has a pink sauce, sir. I wouldn't say it was all that bright a pink, sir. Just a nice, pleasant pink, sir.
Like the Financial Times.
Or Sally Oppenheim's new panties.
I'll have the chicken with that pale grey sauce that tastes of underfelt.
And for me, I suppose.
Cheese, pinch melba, or queen of puddings.
Queen of puddings?
They added it to the menu when Richard Marsh got his knighthood.
For services, most of which either arrived late or were cancelled owing to points failure.
I'll have the cheese, please.
I can't make up my mind between Melba and Mam.
There'll be jam on Mam.
That's what I'm afraid of. I'll have the peach Melba.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Well, 7 glorious weeks away from it all.
No more all-night sittings.
No more histrionics from Andrew Foles.
No more bull from Eric Heffer.
No more rounding up the invalids to get them in to vote, dead or alive. There were times when it wasn't so much a chamber as a bedpan.
Different for you socialists, of course. All you have to do is send a fleet of Rolls Royces to the London Clinic and yank all your malingerers out of their private booper beds.
I say, Mellors, old man.
Yes?
Shall we come to a little pact? While we're in Lytham, shall we agree not to talk politics?
Well, certainly. Suits me.
No politics of any kind.
Agree.
Soup, gentlemen.
We were fruit juice.
Were you?
Definitely.
Oh, sorry about that. Would either of you gentlemen be a Mr. Vincent Mellors, MP?
Yes, that's me.
A note for you, sir.
Note?
Perhaps it's from Mrs. Thatcher, asking you to go back and help Dennis distemper the loggia.
Who gave you this?
Gentleman sitting at the end table in the non-smoky. Oh, he's gone. Oh, he paid his bill. He was on the first sitting.
What did he look like?
Oh, didn't pay much attention, sir. He was reading Jean Rook in the Daily Express. Upside down.
Upside down?
Yeah, struck me as funny, sir. Unless he didn't want to be seen. Wanted to conceal himself,
in
like.
In which case, Jean Rook's as good cover as anyone.
If you see this chap again on the train, let me know, will you?
Yes, sir. It was fish to follow, wasn't it?
Chicken?
Oh, sorry about that.
What does the note say?
It says, when you're in Lytham, don't get mixed up in anything that doesn't concern you. Just a friendly bit of advice.
Signed?
No. Friendly is misspelt. E before I.
That's the way it ought to be spelt, isn't it?
No, old man. I before E.
You sure?
Now you've started asking the sort of damnful questions which socialists always ask, I'm not at all sure. Odd, isn't it, this note?
Distinctly odd.
Well, some cracked, I suppose.
Perhaps they're after home rule for Lytham St Annes and are planning to hold demos on the 18th.
18th? That's the day after tomorrow.
I meant the 18th green.
How long is it since you stayed in this hotel we're going to, the Avant-Garde?
Oh, 3 years, I suppose.
They've tarted it up quite a bit. They now have Muzak.
No.
No, but yes. You shall have Muzak wherever you go.
Afternoon, gentlemen. You have reservations?
Yes, my PA rang you. My name is Mellors, Vincent Mellors. This is, well, in a manner of speaking, a friend of mine, Mr. Sellers, Mr. Arnold Sellers.
One of my PAs rang you?
Oh, yes, of course, gentlemen. Politicians, aren't you?
There seems no point in denying the fact.
Would you mind signing, please? It's blowy outside, isn't it? And for 4, 7, or 8 gale, the forecast said, so it'll calm down likely. As we knew you was both in the same racket and would likely want to be talking things over, we put you in adjacent rooms, 28 and 29, with intercommunicating door.
Oh, God.
And there's a parcel left for you, Mr. Mellor, sir.
Parcel?
We had staying with us until last night. Lousy with politicians we've been. Almost as bad as when the conferences are on in Blackpool. Sir Bertram Oliphant? He was something important, wasn't he, sir?
B.O.? He was once Under Secretary of State for Foreign Affairs.
Got the golden handshake for trying to sell...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.